Welcome to SSC JEE aspirants. So this is the second part of the video regarding section analysis. So ee roju ee video lo manam em nechukobothunnam ante DRCS nunchi manaku chaala questions vastayi. So ee topics nunchi vastayi, ee vidhanga questions frame avutayi, adi ela questions SSC JEE lo manalu adugutunnaru ane vishayanni ee video lo meeku cheptanu nenu prayatnam chestunnanu. So actually ga mana design philosophies ani manaku 3 methods unnayi. First method is working stress method, second one is ultimate load method, third method is limit statement. So manam SSC JEE aspirants ka mana main ga concentration cheyalsina area entante limit statement. This is very very important topic in DRCS. Means actually ga limit statement method ki manaku oka code undi, aa code entante IS 456 2000. So this is our Indian standard code we are using for limit state design of various beams, slabs, columns, footings and deflections of various members also we are doing under limit state method. So actually what is the parental method? Ante parental method ante mundu a method vachindi designs ki tarvata ela improvement jarugutha vachindante the parent method is working stress method. So for all design philosophies at present are driven from this working stress method. So this is the oldest and parental method. Okay, fine. So working stress method, ultimate load method, limit state method, about these three methods I will explain each one in each video about 5 minutes for each topic. And working stress method ante enti anedi oka video lo meeku clear ga cheptanu. Ultimate load method ante enti anedi clear ga cheptanu. Limit state method nunchi manam syllabus ni continue cheyalam. So limit ultimate load method meeda meeru concentration cheyalasina pane em ledu, deen nunchi questions em raavu. Working stress meeda konni manam nechukovalsindi undi, ante working stress method lo manam main ga concentration cheyalasindi singly reinforced beam and doubly reinforced beam. So singly reinforced beam and doubly reinforced beam we have to concentrate under working stress method as well as in limit state method. So before going to explain all these three, for brief I am going to discuss about this casting a slab. Generally when you are casting a slab, which grade you will prefer? I am asking you one. For casting a slab, which grade of concrete you will use? Maybe you are thinking you are putting a stone on me, that M10, M15, M20, right? So generally there are so many considerations we have to consider for selection of a grade for casting any member. Generally for slabs we are going to cast the slab with M20 concrete. M20 concrete. So why? Because M20 we have M5, M10, M15, M20 also. But M20 has more workability. So when you casting a slab or a column or a beam, the concrete has to go very fastly to penetrate into the corners of the column and the corners of the slab and the corners of the beams, and uniformity of the mixture should be there. And బీమ్ అంతా కూడా యూనిఫామ్ గా కాంక్రీట్ ప్లేస్ అవ్వాలి. అంటే ఒక చోట ఒకలాగా ఒక చోట ఉంటే యూనిఫామిటీ స్ట్రెంత్ అనేది మిస్ అవుతుంది, అప్పుడు వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఫేస్ సమ్ క్రాక్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అండ్ డిఫ్లెక్షన్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ లైక్ దాట్. సో M20లో మనకి జనరల్గా గ్రేడ్ రేషియో చూస్తే 1:1.5:3 మనందరికి బాగా తెలుసు. ఈ రేషియోస్ మనకు బాగా తెలుసు, కానీ ఎగ్జామ్ వచ్చేసరికి మనం కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అవుతూ ఉంటాం. M20 రేషియో మనకు తెలియదు, M10 రేషియో తెలియదు, M15 రేషియో తెలియదు, M20 ఇది మాత్రం గుర్తుంటుంది. సో M20 రేషియో అంటే 1:1.5:3 మనందరికి బాగా తెలుసు. అన్ని రేషియోస్కి కామన్గా 1 యూనిట్ సిమెంట్ ఉంటుంది. సో హియర్ 1 బిలాంగ్స్ టు సిమెంట్. సిమెంట్ అంటే తెలుసు కదా, సిమెంట్ అంటే మనకి బయట సిమెంట్ ప్రొడక్షన్ కంపెనీస్ దగ్గర కానీ దాన్ని డీల్ చేసే డీలర్ షాప్ దగ్గర కానీ మనం వెళ్తే మీకు బ్యాగ్స్ పైన ఇలా బ్యాగ్ ఉందనుకోండి, పైన చాలా సిమెంట్ కంపెనీస్ మనకు ఉన్నాయి. దాని మీద మనకు జనరల్గా 33 గ్రేడ్, 43 గ్రేడ్, 53 గ్రేడ్ అని మనకు ఉంటుంది. So, asli we enti, 33 enti, 43 enti, 53. These are the grades of the cement. And before I said about grades of concrete, now I am saying about grades of the cement. So, we have different types of grades of concrete and also different types of grades of cement also there. So, which one we have to choose while you are casting a member? That also very good task we have as a civil engineer. So, second one is filler material. Filler material means nothing but fine aggregate. All civil engineers are very, very well known with fine aggregates. They are nothing but sand. And third one is, this is a strength matter. This is a strength material. In the M20 mix, which one is going to give strength for the coming loads? That only one material is strength material, that is coarse aggregate. Stones. Stones of 15 mm, 20 mm, gravels. And in quarry nunchi ballast chesin tarvata. Ballast means sleeper lone ballast kadu. Adi ballasting ayipoyin tarvata manaku vache crushing tarvata vache stones, gravel stones, granite stones. We are using as a concrete coarse aggregate in this mixture. Okay? Right. So why we are using cement in this mixture? We are using cement in this mixture for bonding. For example, I will take a small example. For example, I will take coarse aggregate. Coarse aggregate. So in coarse aggregate, if you observe very carefully, in coarse aggregate we have voids. I am drawing with red ink, so please observe, these are the voids. So generally you know that if there is any voids in any member or in any soil or in any mixture, if there are voids, the stress distribution is not uniform. So if your stress distribution or the load application should be uniform, means there should be no voids, nothing but the contact surface between members should be very, very minimum. So we are adding sand, nothing but fine aggregate into the coarse aggregate. So this sand will come and will occupy this gaps. Okay. So again, we are adding cement to this mixture. So this cement will come and it will place between the sand particles. Okay. What here is, in coarse aggregate there are some pores, that pores are filled by sand. In sand also there are some pores, that sand pores are filled by the cement. So for a whole homogeneity of the mixture and bonding, cement will act like a binding material. Understand? So cement will act as a binding material, and here sand will be act as a filling material in the concrete mixture, and the coarse aggregate, which one is there in the mixture, will act like a strength material for the mixture. So this is about the mix design. So we have so many types of mix designs and the ratios. So there is a concept called design of mixes. So in the design of mixes, I will clearly take the class about design of mixes. So until then, so please wait for working stress method design in coming videos. Thank you.